Good morning and welcome to Brunico, or Bruneck, depending on which language you speak. We are here because we've designed a route. Stay with us. We haven't ridden it yet, but we think it's going to be fun. That takes the rider around the Zillertal Alps, which is just north of the Dolomites here in Italy, in the region of South Tyrol or Südtirol.
We have called it the Zillertal Trail.
Yeah.
And it's about 177 kilometers with an elevation gain of around 5,000 meters.
It should mostly be cyclable. We just met up with a mountain bike rider who is a local here. He has his reservations about our plan, and honestly, we do too. It's a 6 kilometer stretch that takes you over one particular mountain pass that, even for the leanest mountain bikers, is a little bit tricky. Yeah, we carry luggage with us. I wonder what our conclusions will be, but we'll document it and
we'll test it out.
We'll test it out for you. Of course, you can see the route and everything attached to the collection in Komoot, which is down in the description. And also, we want to say thanks to Komoot once again for supporting the journeys that we are doing throughout this summer. They've been a very, very nice help for us to make this all possible. I think without further ado, it's time to cycle. The weather is great for the next 6 days, so we should be fine there. Let's see what this brings.
Yeah.
Però no, e mañana, come le dico a ella, mañana il pizza di Oja è meno ripido perché è una strada militare.
I think it's the only hike I've ever done. Today's been quite a day, yeah?
It's my food. It's my food. You're a very cute dog.
So, I think I'm gonna add cinnamon again.
Some apple, today. Of course. Today, cinnamon.
Yeah, it's a special morning. First line, up to the second.
Falls through it all. Valley. Funders? Funders was the last town. Then up there, up here, crazy hike a bike. Crazy hike a bike until there. Then we went down, and today we've gone through this valley, and we're zigzagging over here to the border with Austria, the Fitzerjoch. Fujo or Paso, and then we get off the map.
Nice. I think you summed it up. As quite a few of you have shown interest in what we're cooking, to the degree of asking us to publish a little bikepacking cooking book, which we may or may not be working on, I wanted to show you what we're going to eat tonight. We were a bit rushed, we don't carry much food at the moment, so this is a bit of just trying to combine whatever makes sense. We still had marinated tofu, which is very nice. Red lentils, so those go great. A fennel, and two fairly touched carrots. So we're gonna bake, fry these, the fennel and the carrot, and then put the lentils with some water and a stock cube, and add the tofu near the end. And that will make a delicious broth. Also, snacks.
My dirty wash.
So this morning we have rushed into Meierhofen in Austria because today is a special day. Belen and I are splitting up. Not in the sense of relationship, don't worry.
Only 24 hours.
We're gonna split up on the route because on this journey we have anticipated this last climb. There's three climbs on the Zillertal Trail, and the last climb is a killer. 1900 meters up from Meierhofen, and the last 3 kilometers you'll be on slabs of rocks. It's just a terrible place. There's bad weather coming in, so we have a time limit, hence I'm gonna do it alone, and I'm gonna take you with me, and Belen is gonna take trains, come back to Brunico, where we have a friend who's gonna host her for a night. And then hopefully tomorrow I'll be coming down and meeting her in the valley. Now, because we're on a longer journey, you know, stitching all these bikepacking routes with Interrail, we need to have a lot of luggage with us for different situations, all these electronics, etc. And I'm giving a lot of my stuff to Belen because this is essentially just an overnighter. And that's one more advice, I guess, for this trip. If you're doing it just as a solo trip, you're coming to Austria or Italy to do it, then you don't need much stuff at all. And the lighter you are, the better it's going to be for those passes.
It's very important that you're able to lift your bicycle, not necessarily carry it, but at least lift it.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, it's a little bit heavy for me.
Yeah. Well, anyway, this is it. Now you know why all of a sudden I'm going to be alone in the videos. We've stocked up on food. Belen is going to take the train.
And I'll be on the other side.
Yeah, I'm going to climb 1900 meters, I guess. Wish me luck. Fingers crossed. Wait, pickles? Did I hear pickles?
What?
Someone brought pickles?
What?
He has some pickles, yeah.
Yes! Pickles!
Here we go. Cheers.
Cheers.
To the journey. To your scouting trip this morning. My scouting trip this morning.
Successful missions. Mm. Hey, I made it all the way here by train. I got 4 trains.
Yeah.
You didn't miss an Italian train. This is the
right, exactly. And you didn't get in conflict with the conductor.
No.
About your bike. That's pretty exceptional too.
So it's lunchtime. Mm. We just met up. Well, actually, Belen met up with David yesterday already. But guys, meet David. He's a local from this valley in Brunico. And he's been awesome enough to put up Belen for a night while I was in the mountains.
Top job.
Yeah. And then then they both come down to meet, or come up to meet me here this morning, this afternoon. Oh jeez, I'm so tired.
Only recently we were told that cappuccino is only for breakfast.
To here it's always gravel.
Nice.
Then this is
normal
tarmac
secondary road.
Cobblestone, something like this. Then this is gravel, of course, to that.
Yeah, yeah, we think that in the official route we're just gonna keep it going like this.
Mm,
and then put like a highlight here in case you wanna go there.
Mm,
you
mm.
can.
Yeah, but this is cool over there.
We have just rolled into Brunico train station. You know what that means.
We are finished.
We completed the Zillertal trail. And this loop has been quite an adventure. We would say that it's recommendable to avid bikepackers. People who have their luggage skills under control, have a light bike, don't mind a lot of hiker biking, as you've seen. And also maybe spend a bit of money on restaurants and guest houses instead of taking a tent and cooking setup. And with that said, it's also quite a nice recommendation and alternative to the busy Dolomites, especially in the tourist season, because the Zillertal Alps are just more quiet, there's more locals, it's a bit more remote, and we really like that. Other than that, we want to give two big thanks, first of all, to Komoot for making the summer route recycling a possibility. It's very nice of them to help out. And the second thanks goes to David and his family, who have put up Belen and me and given us a wonderful night out and just a great bit of, you know, localizing.
Local experience.
Yeah, it's been fantastic. So thanks, you, Dave. Thanks, David, if you're watching this. We are going to go to Milan now. We're going to take some trains. We're still using the intro passes as we're stitching routes and prep for the next one, which is going to be quite exciting. But you'll see that in the next series. So we see you there.
See you soon.
Ciao, ciao.
Happy to finish this one.